Yes, that's correct. We're seeing a historic victory with the results of this house election.
You've secured well over two-thirds of the seats.
The people have chosen the Citizens' Liberal Party, and with that, we have our mandate.
Prime Minister, how significant was Party Chair Aoki's role in this?
Very, without a doubt. This election came on the heels of Ogikubo-san's retirement, and Aoki-san's achievements were on the citizens' minds.
Party Chair Aoki, how would you respond to that assertion?
The Citizens' Liberal Party is a herald of great change. We've always shown our passion for improving the country. And now it's time to show the people that we're willing to put in the work. Wherever a gray zone's shadow darkens the land, we'll shine light on it. We will succeed where others fail. We will not sit back and tolerate criminals while lining our own pockets.
But you will! That's your whole thing!
These are my principles. They are the reason I founded Bleach Japan 20 years ago. And I'm proud to say, they are the same today.
Oh.
What is it?
What? Oh! Oh! Warrant issued for murder! Get fucked, Aoki! Get fucked, dickhead!
Party Chair, do you have any comments about this report? It says you're wanted for murder.
It's a mistake.
Obviously, is it now?
Some absurd claim by people who have a political agenda against me. And everyone, please remain in your seats as we look into this allegation.
You're trending, sir. The buzz on social media is that Ryo Aoki isn't even your real name. Is that true?
Ooh, Nick! Fucking get him, Nick!
They're saying your real name is Masato Arakawa. In Yokohama the other day, a gang leader named Masumi Arakawa was killed. Could it be that he was your father?
Ooh, Nick!
You can't just walk away! Face the public and explain! I saw it on your face! You recognize the name Masato Arakawa! Party Chair! Is Ryo Aoki your true name?
Aw, oh, get fucked, Masato!
I told you, Tendo isn't picking up. I've called him several times already. And there's no answer at the Arakawa family office either. And you, Commissioner, what the hell's going on? Why is there a warrant for my arrest?
I'm looking into that. The news report might not have gone out yet. It's possible it only got broadcast at the Citizens Liberal Party headquarters. I'm trying to confirm.
Even if that's the case, it was a live broadcast. So what's the difference? Plenty of people saw that damn ticker. I need to be able to explain who did that and why immediately.
This is just a snag, but don't do anything rash. I think you should avoid the Millennium Tower, too.
I can't avoid it. If Ichiban Kasuga finds that evidence at the Arakawa family office, this is more than just a snag. And it'd be hell for you too, by the way. You'd have to cover for me. The risk is too high to ignore.
Oh man, he's fucking screwed.
I still can't get in touch with Tendo-san, but I managed to talk to some men who said they were going to the tower.
Fine. Assign a few of the strongest ones to act as my personal guard.
Yes, sir. Understood.
Oh, I see where this is going. It's gonna be a fight against Masato and a bunch of fucking goons, a la Jingu and fucking, Munakata. Ugh. Man, your boys fucking suck.
Ichiban was behind all this? Really? Tendo?
Huh? Hey.
Why the fuck weren't you picking up your phone?
As you can see, I was a little busy.
Where's the recording? I want this over and done with.
There is no recording. It was a bluff.
A bluff. I see. So it's just a bluff. I knew it would be.
So, we done here or not?
No. Not yet. We know he must still have accomplices out there somewhere. At the very least, someone who ran that ticker at the same time as the votes were being counted. And we know someone must have been hiding him after the explosion in Ijincho. I refuse to tolerate any chance of another close shave like this.
So, what's your call here?
Hunt them all down. Kill them. Make sure the bodies are never found. Do whatever it takes. I don't want even the slightest chance of any of them getting back up and crawling out of the slums like cockroaches.
Oh, nice.
How'd you like my performance?
I could have won an award for that one, Kasuga.
Right? Maybe I should go do some auditions. So, what you think?
Ichiban, how did you...
Young master, you know me. I hate dying.
Oh, he's so fucking panicked. Hey, Tendo. You fucking piece of shit. No loyalty.
Should have checked your blind spot, Aoki-sensei.
No loyalty whatsoever.
You hired me. And then you made the mistake of treating me like I was some kind of disposable peon.
Huh? What do you mean? What are you talking about?
Oh.
There are two...
What?
Tendos.
I'm impressed.
Mirror Face!
Mirror Face really is the perfect name for you, man.
Mirror?
Oh, shit. Face? Yo, we hired Mirror Face.
That's what they call me. I can make myself...
Oh, my God.
I want to.
Yo!
Wow. This is gonna make one hell of a headline. Tokyo governor orders Yakuza to murder political rival Ichiban Kasuga and his supporters.
Oof.
Scoop of the year.
I got the whole thing on video.
Nice.
Go ahead and post it online. Where at?
Everywhere.
No! Stop
enough!
It.
This is as far as you go, young master. It's time.
Ichiban! Did you... really plan all this? Your dumbass?
I was bluffing when I told you about the tape recording. That was just to lure out Tendo. But I've known you for years. I was pretty sure you wouldn't be satisfied. Not until you saw the results for yourself. You think you can predict what I'm going to do next. But in the end, I know you better than you know me.
You shut your damn mouth.
Young master, I had to do this. It was the only way I could stop you. It's sad, and I know it hurts, but I don't think you even know how to stop yourself.
What?
You only became the governor and a person of influence so that you could get back at an old girlfriend and the police commissioner. But what did you really even get out of that? Now you've pushed everyone who was important to you away. You were blinded by having more power than you knew what to do with. What happened to you? You don't even realize what you've lost. You really thought the only solution was to keep killing anyone who threatened your power in even the smallest way? How could you be that stupid? Why the fuck would you want that kind of life?
You don't know shit about me.
But I'm right, aren't I? Just admit it.
Even if you are, I just need to keep moving forward. And after tonight, No one can stop me.
No. I'll stop you. No matter what.
Men! Kill them all! Leave no one alive!
Oh, man. Okay. Don't know why I just spawned us in like that, but sure.
Make sure they're dead. Got that?
Ryo Aoki, Governor of Tokyo.
Well.
Try this. Yeah.
I'm not back. All right. Let's use all our AoEs. Wow. Yeah, Aoki has some fucking health on him.
Right.
Hey, I got this.
Get this out.
You're in.
Get this one.
He's no Tendo though. You're gonna be
in the too hot. This sucks.
All right, essence of orbital laser. Guard order. Oh.
His bodyguards have him completely protected.
Yeah, can't hit him while he's got that kind of meat shield.
We just have to do this the old-fashioned way. Pick him off one by one.
Watch me.
All right.
Take this. Take this.
Okay. All
right, I mean, this is a lot more men. Well, now there's only a couple of them. I should use the fulminating forecast.
Here we go. Serious. Try this on your side.
Well,
you're gonna get stomped.
Fight.
Hold it together.
Alright, here's the brace. Call backup.
Get over here.
Hey, is he trying to call for help? Well, he's the governor. Why don't he swoop in to save him?
I don't know, but I hope he doesn't have any tanks or anything.
Let him call whoever he wants. Makes no difference to me.
This really is just the Jingu and fucking Munakata fights.
Who was that?
Yeah.
Right.
God, I'm glad I have good AoEs.
Watch me.
Too hot, this sucks.
I'm not backing down.
Eyes on me.
Come on now.
Well.
All right. We're actually just down to Aoki now. He's just weak to physical attacks. That's great.
Here we go.
Back to the real fight.
You know what? Kick it, kick him in the nuts.
Let's do it.
Good shit, Saiko. And he totally deserves it. Alright, you call a singular guy for backup, that's fine.
Watch me
get serious. Take this.
Honestly, let's just fucking take out Aoki. I don't see him doing much once he goes down. Well, yeah, no shit, because he'll be down, you dumbass. Man, how great would it have been if I could have killed him by kicking him in the nuts? Aw, oh, you're running away. Aoki ditched the fight. Fucking bitch. Alright, so all that's just one Tokyo Omi Alliance guy. Oh wow, you are literally no- oh, you call it the backup too? Get the fuck out of here. There we go. Ooh, a lot of job experience on that one.
Hell yeah. Nice.
Essence of bulldozing throw.
Stronger.
Strong. Everyone all right?
Can't say that I am, really.
If only I could move like I did 20 years back.
My body doesn't always do what I want anymore.
Shh, no, let's not look at things like that.
Hang in there, everyone. I know it hurts, but...
Forget about that. Listen, Ichiban, you have to go catch up with Aoki.
Yeah.
Huh? Aoki's by himself right now. This is your chance to give him what he deserves.
Go on, Ichiban. Don't worry, we can handle ourselves.
But what if...
Do you really think so little of us?
Yeah, we're not that weak. Believe it or not, we actually can survive without you. Thought we might have proved that by now.
You guys... Go settle this, Ichiban. Show him how everything he's put you through has only made you stronger.
Yeah, I like that. I'll settle it once and for all. You're all the best friends I've ever had. Thanks, guys!
Alright. Solo, huh? I like this. Let me just heal up a little bit first. No. Oh, there was a heal point right here. Of course there was.
You think you can defeat me, unarmed, one-on-one?
Still so cocky!
Come on, then.
Now we're talking. I'll wipe that stupid grin off your face, and leave it bloody on the floor.
Masato Arakawa. No, no pretenses now.
Cool.
Oh, we're in the freelancer job.
Check this out. Look off.
Man, I'm glad I have a bunch of defense. Pride's roar. Oh, he heals himself too. Ooh, hey, reverse German suplex. Nah. That's not gonna do anything. Let's just punch him. Undying Determination's roar. Ooh, whoa. Fucking QTEs. Oh, that was a good ass fight.
Ichiban. Ichiban. You don't get to do this to me. You fuck!
It's over, young master.
Stop it. Now's my chance. I can finally put this nation on the right path. I can use my power. I've seen the light.
No, you haven't.
And then what? What's that have to do with anything?
And then I can make Japan so much more beautiful. I could do that.
You want?
That's what the masses want. They want peace and prosperity, and I can give it to them.
But the reality is, you just do whatever you want and make other people clean up after you.
What?
No matter who you claim to be now, if anyone disagrees with you, even a little, you toss them aside like they mean nothing. I already know you're just gonna keep using the state of Japan as an excuse to kill the people around you. Just like you did with your father. If I hadn't done anything, you would have killed Captain Sawashiro, even after he served you for more than 20 years.
There are two types of people in this world. Those who use, and those who get used. In other words, people who can make a difference. And people who are just tools in their hands.
Like your father.
He was just one of many tools. Useful while it lasted. I didn't need him anymore.
So what you're saying is that it's fine for certain people to be sacrificed once they've outgrown their use to you?
Are you finally getting the picture?
Like hell I am! You and me, we're like light and shadow, born on the same day. You're the light. Arakawa's heir and legitimate son, who was always given everything I ever wanted. You had all of that from birth. What the hell happened? What changed you? Why'd you turn out like this?
This is the police! Nobody move a muscle!
Kasuga,
These aren't just beat cops. They probably report directly to the commissioner.
Sir! What's going on here?
Why don't you start over from scratch? Come on. That's exactly what you need to do. I know you can crawl back up if you just put in the work. I believe in you. If you're willing to do that, I swear I'll stand by your side the whole time. Just like the old days. For as long as it takes, we can do it. Together. It'd be an honor. You know something? Back when I first joined the family, I promised Arakawa-san that I'd always be there to support you. As you already know, Tendo tried to use a bomb to kill us back in Ijincho. He did all that under the orders of Ryo Aoki. We have video evidence of Aoki's reaction when he found out we were still alive. See for yourself.
We know he must still have accomplices out there somewhere. At the very least, someone who ran that ticker at the same time as the votes were being counted. And we know someone must have been hiding him after the explosion in Ijincho. I refuse to tolerate any chance of another close shave like this.
So, what's your call here?
Hunt them all down. Kill them. Make sure the bodies are never found.
Uh-oh.
Do whatever it takes. I don't want even the slightest chance of any of them getting back up and crawling out of the slums like cockroaches.
This video's already making its rounds on the internet. The Citizens Liberal Party must have more enemies than they think they do, because it's going viral even as we speak.
I think it's fair to say we'll need to consult with the commissioner on this one.
Is it?
He's gonna die.
Things aren't looking good for you, Mr. Governor. We'll need to take you into custody. Why don't you come with us to the precinct?
Well,
you master!
Stay back! Take one step, and I blow his fucking brains out!
Your master! Don't do this!
You want me to give up everything I've built because of some stupid thing Arakawa told you 20 years ago? All this patriarch and oath bullshit. I've always hated how you Yakuza act like you're one big happy family. You go on about duty and honor, and I fucking hate it. I fucking hate it!
Put the gun down, young master, please. If you take a police officer hostage, they're going to kill you, no matter who you are. I don't want to see any more of my family die.
Family? Don't make me laugh. I'm not your fucking family.
No matter what you say, I'll always consider you part of my family. You were the first friend I ever had in my whole life. I wish I could have stopped you. I should have stopped you from losing control, but I didn't. And now we've both lost Arakawa-san forever. So please, don't do this. I couldn't take losing you too. You can still come back.
I'm begging you. You're just like him. Every single damn thing that comes out of your mouth just reminds me of my fucking father. Which is exactly why I never liked you in the first place.
Young master!
I really wonder what's his plan now? What the fuck is he gonna do? There's no coming out of this. Oh.
Knock them all down. Kill them.
Well, now everyone sees it. Hey, Governor. He's gonna wind up in the same fucking staircase that he shot that dude. Oh, the coin lockers. What a fucking coincidence. Started.
I told you. I've known you for 20 odd years. I figured you'd come here. Call it a hunch. I thought maybe some of my words managed to get through to you. Maybe you actually did decide to start over from the bottom and work your way back up. I figured if you did, you'd come back to where Arakawa-san first found you. Where our stories began.
You don't have any idea what I'm going through. I'm tired of your shit, Ichiban.
All we're doing here is having a conversation. So come on. The gun's really not necessary. Why don't you stop pointing that thing and give it to me?
She was a hostess who broke my heart and betrayed me on that New Year's Eve 18 years ago. That night changed our lives forever. Oh. She ended up marrying Horinouchi, you know?
Oh.
Before I became governor, I attended a celebration of his appointment to police commissioner. She was there. She didn't recognize me. Everything about me was so different. Do you know what she said to me? You won't believe it. Oh my. You're so sophisticated and intelligent for a man your age. Crazy, right? Fucking incredible. That damn woman. She was so scared of me. And she calls me a gentleman? What kind of bullshit is that? I swear you couldn't make this shit up. Hilarious, don't you think?
It's okay.
In the end, that's all it amounted to. The power I changed my name for, changed my body for. The power I chased with such blind passion, I killed for it. I started off in life with a weak, ugly body that embarrassed me. I worked hard to improve myself. But after all that, I still wasn't happy because no one appreciated who I really was on the inside.
That's not true, young master. The boss, I mean, Arakawa-san and Captain Sawashiro both cared about you. They always put you first in everything they did. Same for me. After I got out of prison, the first time I saw you was in a picture. I knew it was you right away. There was no mistaking it. I'd recognize your face anywhere. Because I care about you too.
Are you lecturing me again about how important family is?
No! It's not a lecture! Did you ever stop to think why Arakawa-san, Captain Sawashiro, and I never gave up on you? No matter how much bad shit you dragged us into! Let me tell you. It wasn't easy. But we did it anyway, because we're all connected, deep inside our hearts. You see things in black and white, but family's not that simple. No one appreciated you for who you are? Bullshit! We were always there for you. We would have done anything for you, gone to hell and back. All you had to do was ask! When will you believe me when I say the three of us loved you? Or are you just gonna keep pointing that gun on your head like a dumbass?
Ichi.
This may not be what you want to hear, but you know, I consider you my brother, man. That means something to me. Don't make me watch my brother die. Please. I can't do it. Asato. I'm begging you.
Mr. Governor, where are you?
Sorry, I didn't mean to worry you. I'm going to turn myself in. Would you mind taking care of the... No, never mind. You're free to do as you like. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Aw, man. Are you fucking kidding me?
How could you betray us, Aoki-san? I put my faith in you. I believed your words. I thought you
Kume!
Had a noble path, bleached pure and clean. But it's not too late. True righteousness will triumph.
Fucking Kume. Oh my god, that little fucker. I don't even know what the fuck to say, man. Like, wow. That was... that was incredible. I kind of want to give my final thoughts, but I know that there's an after credits scene, because there always is in a Yakuza game. So I kind of want to wait, but at the same time, it's like, oh my god, like, I have to say something here, because holy shit, that was... You know, I'm really glad that the director for the Yakuza series confirmed that, yeah, we're getting more games. And we're getting more games with Ichi as the protagonist. So, I cannot wait to fucking lay the beat down on Sota Kume. Oh, man. That whole shit at the end with Ichi saying how he... Sawashiro and Arakawa loved Masato the whole time they would have done it. Oh, that shit made me fucking tear up. Made my nose run a little bit too. I was tempted to go grab a tissue and blow my nose real quick. But I can't mute my mic without without pausing the game. So that would have been a little weird. Hey, I'll give my final thoughts on this game on the after credits scene. I might as well give my thoughts on... continue to give my thoughts on that last part there. Oh, goddamn, that was great. And I love that parallel at the end, where in the beginning of the game, we saw Arakawa running off with baby Masato in his hands to get him to the hospital. And then what do we have at the end? Ichi... the dying Arakawa in his arms, running off to the hospital to save him. Like, I love the fucking parallels. It's incredible. One thing I do want to say too, like, I fucking love the characters in this game. I think easily one of my favorite characters in this game was Arakawa. But I always absolutely love the father figures in the Yakuza series. Like Kazuma, especially Arakawa here. I think Arakawa might actually be one of my, well, my new favorite. Just how much of a fucking, I mean, not to say that Kazuma-san wasn't a fucking badass, but like, I absolutely loved Arakawa. Like, oh man. I can't get over how good this shit was. And also, the ending song here, Ichibanka. I fucking love this song too. Yo, shoutouts to Scott Streichart, the localization director for this game. Crushed it. Absolutely incredible job. Everyone involved did a great job. Then again, I expect nothing less from a Yakuza game. You know, I love how how long ago did I start playing Yakuza? I think when I was in my third year of college, I started playing Yakuza 0 when it came out. And I'm really glad I decided to take an interest in it when I saw someone else playing it. Because I've been in love with the series ever since. And it's an incredible series, to be fair. Like, it's great. Like, you feel such a wide range of emotions playing the Yakuza games. In one minute, you'll be going, oh, like, you'll be so hyped up because it's so fucking cool. You'll be laughing your ass off in the next minute. Fucking Oats Joy. You'll be laughing your ass off in the next minute. Then you'll be sobbing your fucking eyes out in the next. Like, I absolutely adore the wide range of emotions that you fucking go through in these games. It's great. And I am so looking forward to Yakuza 8 whenever it gets announced and released here. I'm glad I had, like, absolutely no idea what the story was like in this game going into it. And I plan on doing the same thing with 8 when it comes out. Because, what a fucking ride this has been. Alright. I wonder, did Horinouchi ever get his? Oh, Adachi.
I'm glad you decided to show up, Horinouchi-san.
Of course. You must be him. The man who sent me that anonymous tip. As I recall, you're Kanagawa police.
The name's Adachi. I was at the driver's license center, but I was dishonorably discharged just before I hit retirement. Hey, you know, this didn't happen too long ago. Don't tell me you don't remember me.
Your point? I'm a very busy man, you know. Don't waste my time, please. Look, you said there was a crime the Tokyo Omi Alliance had gone unpunished for. Can we get to that?
I found some pretty explosive evidence at the Arakawa family office in the Millennium Tower. I'm not sure if you know this, but supposedly there was an audio recording somewhere in the office that would implicate Governor Aoki in Masumi Arakawa's murder.
But that was just a bluff by Ichiban Kasuga and his accomplices. It was bait to lure out Tendo and the governor. A trap to record Aoki admitting to his crimes.
I knew you'd have a good grasp of it.
Well, time to arrest Horinouchi.
Oh, you brought company.
Or now?
These guys your subordinates?
I'm the police commissioner. Every officer is my subordinate.
Fair enough.
What's that?
The recording might have been a hoax, but when Tendo and the Omi searched the family office, they found something else that was very interesting.
Oh?
Simply put,
it's oh, fuck.
The Arakawa family payroll.
Is it?
Apparently, not long after the Kamurocho 3K plan started, Masumi Arakawa transferred a total of 300 million yen to various officials in public roles. Shame he was killed the other day, huh?
Yeah.
You know, I think he could have explained in detail what all these obvious bribes were about. But at least we have this list here, which shows exactly into whose hands each yen landed. That's right. The whole list is here. It was all on Captain Sawashiro's computer. Great news for us.
Man, Sawashiro.
What's up? Oh, you're looking kind of pale, Commissioner. Is something wrong? Masumi Arakawa's 300 mil took crazy complicated routes through a bunch of foreign bank accounts. Eventually found its way to you and other high-ranking officers.
Crazy that.
I know it was all in exchange for turning a blind eye toward the Omi Alliance activities in Kamurocho. For real, I gotta hand it to Arakawa for hiding the flow of this money so well, but lucky for us, this list makes it pretty clear. So, all we need is some supporting evidence, and then the arrests from this little guy are gonna knock out dozens of top officials, including you, police commissioner.
Arrest this man! Confiscate whatever you find on him!
Nah.
What's wrong? Those are my orders.
Struggle all you want. It's too late now, you moron. I already sent this to the Inspector General at Police HQ.
Get fucked, Horinouchi. Right.
Toss the same thing over to the media, so your time's running out. Tick tock, Commissioner.
You're bluffing. This whole scheme wouldn't benefit you at all. You'd be just as poor afterward as you are now.
No, this isn't a bluff, unfortunately for you. It's a victory for me.
Way to go, Adachi! Getting your fucking revenge!
Commissioner, the Inspector General is eager to have a word with you.
What?
I'm sure you didn't take the money purely for personal gain. You had a duty to protect the peace in Kamurocho. After the Tojo clan disappeared, you had no choice but to allow the Omi to take over and stabilize the area. In that sense, you might have even felt you were justified in taking the bribe because of the position you were in. I feel for you. You were caught between a rock and a hard place, weren't you? But on the other hand, sir...
What?
What a coincidence that doing the right thing for the city also happened to line your own pockets. How much was it exactly? 1 mil? 10 mil? Even more? Well, I'm sure we'll find out once we analyze the data. You handed out bribe money to avoid taking responsibility for the city's crime rate. Plus, you even got to skim some for yourself. People who have so much always want more. Why don't you just admit you did it to save your own damn skin? Just like the old days, eh, Horinouchi?
Bastard.
You know, I've been waiting for years to see exactly that look on your face.
This is a trap. A conspiracy. I won't stand for it.
Get fucked, idiot.
Let go of me. I order you to let go of me.
Oh, yeah. Mind if I ask you one more thing? Do you remember New Year's Eve 18 years ago? There was this rude Yakuza who cock-blocked you from your own wife at a hostess club in Kamurocho.
What did you say?
Ah,
Good shit, Adachi. Great to see him get what's coming to him. Oh man, this is gonna be a long, you know, I'm gonna keep it one episode though. I want this to stay as one. Well, I might cut it up. Where's the probably everyone, right?
Ichiban. Joe Sawashiro received his sentence. He got life in prison.
That sounds about right.
Yeah. In fact, I was just telling the boss all about how everything shook out. It's just tragic. Masato Arakawa died without ever knowing Sawashiro was his father. And Masami Arakawa died without ever knowing what happened at the lockers that night. And that you were his real son.
Damn, Joe.
A DNA test?
Yeah. Why not? It's the only way to prove once and for all if Arakawa really was your dad. Don't you want to know for sure? Otherwise, you're gonna have doubts for the rest of your life. I mean, if I were in your shoes, I'd want to know.
Not me, man. The way I see it, I have two dads.
Aww.
Huh?
My fathers are Jiro Kasuga, owner of Shangri-La, and Masumi Arakawa. It doesn't matter which one I'm related to by blood. Nothing can change the fact that they both raised me and made me who I am today. I don't need a test.
Okay. That's something, man.
Huh? Oh, there you are. What are you guys doing in here? The services are starting. Let's go say goodbye to the Arakawas.
All right, let's go.
Tojo guys too.
Kasuga, good to see you.
Likewise. I heard about what you've been up to. You started a security company in Sotenbori.
Yeah, that's right. We had to do something for all the guys who had their rug swept out from under them. Their Yakuza in the wind. I saw it all coming, so I wanted to give them somewhere to go.
Originally, Arakawa-san was supposed to help us put the whole plan in motion.
Yeah. I heard something about that.
Well,
What's your next move, Kasuga? You with us?
Yeah, sounds like your dad had some unfinished business. Why don't you come to Osaka and wrap this up for him?
I think hell just froze over. The mad dog of Shimano was giving perfectly reasonable advice.
Yeah, really.
Don't get used to it. Today's an exception. Tomorrow it's back to balls out.
Dude.
I appreciate the invitation, but I can't. Ijincho is my home. Looking back on it, in Komurocho, I was drifting all by myself. But here in this town, I found my people, and nothing can replace them. You see, I owe them, and I need to pay them all back for what they did for me. Ijincho and Sotenbori should be places where people can go when they're lost. Safe havens when there's nowhere left to turn. So you see, I can take care of the boss's unfinished business right where I am now. That's my plan anyway.
I get it. Makes sense to me.
Guys doing here?
Well, Namba here was all worried about you. He thought the ex-Tojo guys might be looking to snatch you up, Kasuga-kun.
Aww.
Hey, I said to keep that shit on the down low.
So, what'd you say to those old thugs? You gonna leave town and forget all about us little guys?
Zachan, how about you tell him?
What?
I can't say all that mushy shit again while I'm sober.
Well...
Wow, I didn't think he loved us that much.
Did he say it just like that? How cute.
Sounds like the Kasuga-san I know.
Finally. I've gotten to a point in my life where I can't be replaced. What an honor.
Hey, as long as I'm in there, he's got good taste.
Masato said to her.
Once you're at rock bottom, the only place to go is up. There's no shame in being at the bottom. All that matters is how you decide to climb back out of the darkness. There's always a ray of hope up there. I was lucky to learn that from you, young master.
Oh What a good ass game. And again, I love how it gives us a villain for the next game. Sota Kume. Man, fuck that guy. Like, alright, final thoughts. You know, I'm gonna be honest. Like everyone else, I kinda have some doubts about Yakuza being in a turn-based RPG. Although, you know, I love turn-based RPGs. I mean, you guys know that. But, you know, considering how the old Yakuza games were, I kind of had a little bit of doubt. Like, oh, are they going to be able to pull it off? Is it going to be weird? Or, like, so, you know, I had some slight doubts. But as I saw more of it, and, you know, as I played it, I can easily say I think this is my favorite Yakuza style of combat that I've played in a long time. Not to say, again, that I don't like the beat-em-ups. I think I just like the turn-based style more. And that's one of the reasons why I'm glad we're getting Ichi as our protagonist for at least a couple more games. Because we're going to have this system come back again. But yeah, everything about... I think this was easily my game of the year 2020. Like, I loved everything about this. The gameplay, the characters, the story, the music. Like, everything about it was incredible. And I am so happy that I got to play through it completely blind with you guys. So for those of you who stuck around and watched the whole way through, thank you so much for doing so. I realize I've kind of had some not great time keeping up with my schedule, especially this month because of my work. But I really do appreciate you guys keeping up with this, even when I wasn't. I appreciate you guys really watching the series and really liking it. I'm glad that I feel like maybe this playthrough has gotten some of you guys into it, which I couldn't be more happy about. Because I feel like everyone should experience these games at least once. Because they are just that much of a fucking ride. And I feel like ever since 7 came out, we've kind of had a resurgence of people getting into Yakuza for the first time, whether it's with this game or some people starting at 0 and then working their way up. Either way, I couldn't be happier that more people are getting into this, because, like I said, it is just an experience that I think everyone should have. It's that great. I love this series that much. It's wacky. It can get ridiculous at times, don't get me fucking wrong. But it'll make you feel incredible afterward. Certain moments will make you laugh your ass off. Certain moments will absolutely crush and twist your heart. But at the end of the day, I can say that these are easily some of the finest games I've ever played in my life. And I'm really looking forward to whatever Ryuga Gotoku Studios does next. That's how much I love this stuff. So on that note, I'll leave you all off here. Thank you again so much for watching this series. I had so much fun with it, and I hope you guys did too. Honestly, I really don't know what I'm going to be doing next. I'll probably be getting back to FGO, in case anyone's interested in that. But the next game I plan on playing will probably be whatever comes out first between Nier Replicant or SMT5, probably. So yeah. Oh, actually, no, what am I talking about? February. February, Persona 5 Strikers comes out. I'll be playing that. That's probably what I'm... The next big thing I'm going to be playing, anyway. So yeah. Once again, thank you all so much. I hope you enjoyed this crazy, wild ride as much as I did. And whenever Yakuza 8 does come out, you know I'm going to be playing it right here. So, I'll see you guys around. Bye.